Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera. A very good day. Distinguished participants and committee of offshore site investigation. This is to me an honor to be part of the event. Thank you for inviting me, especially to my friend Dr. Bashir Uzani, who trust me to deliver this presentation. For my distinguished audience in this event, I have prepared a topic entitled Offshore Hydrography and Ocean Surveys. The purpose of this presentation is to sum up iconic features of hydrographic and ocean products, primarily for offshore energy exploration and exploitation. The primary materials are originated from my personal experiences with a specialist company where I was occasionally invited as an associate expert in serving part of maritime industry in this sector. I feel thankful to my colleague and friends from the maritime industry who have been entrusting me to get involved in their problem solving. The entire content of this talk is organized into four primary headings. The first will be the proposed definition of hydrography and met ocean. This will be followed by display of typical data and product and their support to offshore investigation. Series of examples are given in the next heading, being the examples of application, of course. And my talk will be concluded by comment on accuracy and remark on how to decide on carrying out a met-ocean study. Hydrography has been traditionally known for ocean surveying, supporting various positioning works and providing bathymetric information and sounding datum. Nautical chart is perhaps the most prominent hydrographic product used worldwide. It is dedicated to facilitate safe and efficient navigation and can be used as baseline of spatial information for wider applications in marine sectors, including met ocean studies for offshore investigation. On the other hand, met ocean information deals with the water column, sea surface, and atmospheric layers, particularly weather and climate just above the sea surface. Here I show an example of a typical met ocean report showing selected water column and sea surface parameters here on the right hand side. These include current, water level, tide, surge, wave, and wind. Yeah. The presentation of the report could be in printed form, a hard copy report, or digital database as it is shown in this slide. With this, one can click anywhere in the interface map or key in the specific geodetic coordinates to access a pop-up table showing the magnitudes of all met ocean parameters available. Basically, hydrographic and met ocean data are usually collected by means of direct or in-situ surveys. The portable survey devices are available in the market, and options are commercially affordable for quite a wide range of company sizes. Delicate technology such as global observation satellites facilitates continuous observation by means of remote or indirect sensing. Primary survey is usually preferable as it provides first-hand information of any parameters being investigated. Once acquired, field data undergoes various techniques of analysis depending on the intended purpose of the observation itself. Hydrographic survey data is typically presented as bathymetric and benthic cover maps showing seabed properties along with the definition of the tidal heights. Meteorological observation data is typically used to generate insights on wind and other atmospheric parameters relevant to offshore operation, such as rainfall and air temperature. Oceanographic measurement data is delivered in form of current and waves, including other types of non-tidal sea surface variations. Occasionally, extended studies are required in order to investigate the specific characteristics that prevail in the domain in question, like erosion, internal solitary wave, or soliton, or even perhaps tsunami. This is an example of a presentation of tidal heights obtained by applying harmonic analysis to short period of water level observation. One can observe the vertical relation of tidal phases with respect to a specified vertical reference. This slide exhibits an example of a snapshot from simulation of surge following an event of tropical cyclone. Numerical simulation is applied here to relate the prevailing wind speed and direction to the generation of water level setup and its spatial distribution. The common support of hydrography and mid-ocean to offshore sectors are mainly the derivation of environmental constraints for civil design and planning of a launch mission. Mid-ocean design criteria here is usually the most demanded product for this particular purpose. Yeah. It entails at least climatology, extremes, and what-if analysis. A launch mission usually requires pre-planning by utilizing downtime probability analysis. When the date is approaching, long-range or two-week ahead forecast is usually used. During the operation, short-term forecast is usually accompanying the crew on board for hour by hour. Yeah. To make decision go, hold, or stop, no go. The following four slides are presented to exhibit impression of the selected mid-ocean product. This is an example of a map showing the probability of two-dimensional current speed exceeding 0.5 meter per second, developed as one aspect for tidal power harvesting. The map is constructed according to numerical hydrodynamic simulation. In this slide, we see an example of prediction of extremes. The prediction curve is calculated applying Gumbel procedure according to block of maxima series sample. Yeah, the sample is annual data of at least 10 years back. Here we see an example of prediction of downtime probability for a given location, period of examination, and the required length of consecutive operation. Either you are going to go with 6 days or 14 days here in the example. The estimation is done considering the longest possible daily data and the required threshold of operation. This is perhaps the most known example of mid-ocean product on board, showing spatial distribution of sea state along with tabulated values of the forecasted magnitude. Global and regional operational atmospheric model is downscaled for the focus area and used to predict the sea state. Here, current field is separately predicted according to numerical hydrodynamic simulation. Distinguished participants, beyond this extended hydrographic and mid-ocean products, accuracy is almost always the intriguing question. In general, survey industry accepts the accuracy statement within the 95% confidence interval. However, this shall be limited on hydrographic products, entailing mainly positioning and depth data. mid-ocean parameters are far more complex. Yeah? Statement of accuracy can be presented on the basis of absolute magnitude, usually obtained by comparing the prediction and the observation. Yeah? The predictability of mid-ocean parameters decreases along with the complexity of the natural processes involved. One can see here that there is a contrast of order of accuracy between the prediction of current and morphological change. For instance, here, yeah, in case of a qualitative event such as rain or storm, heat rate is usually counted according to four different classes. Yeah, if the prediction hit miss, create false alarm, and correct rejection. And then this will be quantified according to the percentage. Back to the absolute magnitude based assessment of accuracy. Here I show an example of contrast of accuracy assessment. Yeah, on the left hand side here. Yeah. You could observe a snapshot of an event of a maximum flood current with a distinct range of magnitude. Yeah, in this instance from 0 to up to 2 meters per second. Yeah, on the right hand side, the resulting change of morphology is indicated by relative measure of potential erosion or deposition. Yeah? Because of that inaccuracy, we are happy already to see that the trend is similar. Yeah, in case of modeling of the morphological change. Yeah. Despite its complexity, mid-ocean information is accessible from various sources. Here I prepare a list of sources of reliable mid-ocean information, yeah, either from here, state-owned meteorological office, or portal operated by a multinational consortium. Another option would be, of course, to go for a specialist company, yeah, in this particular industry. Yeah. Even it is free, mid-ocean information may appear as a cool presentation, yeah, like it is shown here. Yeah. Nowadays, there are already several nice operational mid-ocean interface accessible through internet, yeah, and they are free. Yeah. This is the good thing. Distinguished participants, we are close to the last slide of my talk. When one would start obtaining hydrographic and mid-ocean information, I could suggest to start looking at three sources of information listed here. Yeah. The first is perhaps the global data. Nowadays is very resourceful. Yeah. You can see here that we can simply download bathymetry, tide, yeah, weather, yeah, general in general sense, and even wife climate map, yeah, from this global data. Yeah. Bathymetry of world ocean at 15 arc second, yeah, while that tide is at 1/8 arc degree resolution, quite good, yeah, for a global coverage, yeah. And hindcast of mid-ocean parameters at 2.5 degree, yeah, are to name examples of these sets of data. State agency may also provide public access to mid-ocean data, sometimes including also event warning. Yeah, so very useful information. Yeah. Another useful source is options of technical reports. Yeah. There are so very many technical reports available on the internet, and they speak about a specific site. Yeah. On a specific parameters as well, yeah. So with this, I would like to end my talk. Thank you for your kind attention. Salam sejahtera. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.